healing. Welcome to VLOGSGIVING, day 29. Today is Thursday, November the 29th, and I am in Betsy right now. So you guys get to see Betsy. There's Betsy back there. Look at my car. Oh my gosh, it's so funny when I ride in her now. It's like, I can't believe I'm not riding in her anymore, you know, on a day-to-day basis. But so anyway, I am just now starting out my vlog, obviously. And it is late afternoon or early afternoon. I don't know what you call 3 o'clock. Is that late afternoon or early afternoon? But anyway, we are actually pulling up to the bank right now because we have a little bit of a dilemma with the paint situation. And we are going to have to do an ACH stop payment because our contractors, it's a long story, but basically we no longer have them. And so because of that, we have to protect ourselves, and we had tried to work with them, but they just didn't really want to work with us. So we're having to do an ACH stop payment to get our money back, and then we'll be willing to pay them for the work they already did. So it's a long story, but we're doing what we have to do. And hopefully the other contractor that we had initially got an estimate on that was within our price range, hopefully he can pick up the contract and finish it off for us. Hopefully, I want it done because I need my room done. So hopefully, like, I would love for him to start tomorrow, but as of right now, we haven't heard back from him yet. So hopefully, but anyway, I'm gonna run into the bank and then I will give you guys a little bit more details in a little bit. Hey there, Sugar Pies, how we doing? How we feeling? Okay, so it is, what time is it? It's 11:06 at night. A lot has transpired since I last said hi to you all. So I am actually sitting in my car. I'm in my garage, and I have my little light thing working. And I thought, you know what? I need to finish out my vlog because obviously I didn't. What is that? I'm trying to figure out where that color is coming from. I have no idea. There is a weird color. Anyway, so a lot has transpired since I last chatted with you all. I did go to the bank and I took care of this ACH stop payment. And when I got out, I sent her an email just kind of letting her know what has transpired. And I guess I should probably explain a little bit more so that you'll kind of have an idea of what is going on. So, it's the same people that painted our house, which, you know, we had a few minor issues with them with painting the house, but we were like, you know what? We trust them. They're, I don't mind them being in my home because they're good people. They just have a few little quirks about them. And, we had worked out a deal because our lowest contractor estimate was not them. They were the next lowest. But because I was more comfortable with them, I did email them asking would they be interested in a compromised amount. So we met in a happy place in the medium where both of us was happy about. And so, you know, things should be good at that point. Well, last night I got an email saying that they had undercharged us because they counted only 4 rooms instead of 5 rooms. And I was like, okay, whose fault is that? You know, like I wasn't sure what she was asking me. So I was like, you know, I asked several questions. I was like, I'm trying to understand what it is you're wanting it from us. And basically a long story short is they wanted us to pay an extra $175. And I was like, well, we are not doing that because, you know, we thought we were getting, you know, whatever. And so, but, you know, and of course, you know, it was like, well, you know, we would be losing money, blase, blase. So my thought was at this point, I was like, you know what, in order to keep the friendship, in order to keep, and not like we're friends, but you know what I mean? Like keep a good professional friendship type of a thing. Let's just cut our ties. You know, we'll pay you for the price of the room that you painted. If you come back and finish it, we'll pay you the full amount that for painting the one room. And then, of course, we'll buy the paint from you that you have purchased already, because of course she stated that they had purchased the paint. We just need the receipts to show proof that you purchased the paint. I didn't realize she wasn't trying to do that. I thought she was on board with what I was asking. Of course, then they came back and said, hey, you know, but we don't mind going ahead and finishing. We'll just do it at the price that we quoted you. And we're like, well, no, you know, that's not fair to y'all either. You already had compromised your price by agreeing at a happy medium between us and the other contractor. We don't want to ask you to do that. That's not our intent. If we don't want you to lose money, if we cut our ties now, then everybody's happy. We can contact the other contractor. We can go with the other contractor. Then you guys would not be out of any money. Like, you know, and the part that got me was that I don't know why they couldn't understand that we were trying to keep them from being out of money. Like, we don't want you to lose money on our deal. And we understand because, you know, we got several estimates and everybody have their level of what they need in order to for their business to function. And, you know, we're be someone asking you to compromise any more than what you've already compromised. So the emails went back and forth, and basically it went to the point of they didn't show back up today, which they were supposed to be here at 9 o'clock this morning. All of the emails we had last night, I'm thinking that he's going to be here at 9 o'clock this morning. And no show. And basically, because we weren't going to use them to finish, they decided not to come back and do and complete the room. And we'd already paid them a deposit, which would have covered the cost of the room per the email that she told us how much they charge for each room. And so we were like, okay, well then we're forced to do a stop payment. And if you're not willing to work with us, like if you're not willing to work with us in order for everybody to be happy, then we have to pursue another route. And so even at doing the stop payment, what I decided to do, you know, and I sent her an email just explaining, you know, this is what we've decided to do because we're trying to make it as easy as possible on both of us where nobody loses. We're not trying to take money from you. You did paint the room. You just didn't complete it. So we will give you a fair deal of an amount for painting it, but not completing it. Like, we're not going to give you the full asking amount for completing it because you didn't complete it. But, and then since you're not willing to return the paint, then of course you're not going to get paid for any of the paint except for what was used on the wall, and we'll guesstimate it how much was used on the wall unless you're able to provide us with some proof showing what was used on the wall, and then we'll give you, you know, whatever the receipt says on that. But they were just not willing to work. And then of course then it went to the stupid emails where they start sending you unprofessional emails, and I was just like, I'm not dignifying this with an answer. So as of right now, they are no longer our contractors. But the guy that had agreed to do the job before, he's going to come in tomorrow morning and hopefully get started, be able to knock it out. And I'm praying that he can either start tomorrow after he looks at everything, or he can come first thing Saturday morning and knock it out on Saturday morning. That is my hope and my prayer, because I want to put my tree up. I haven't put my tree up. I put my tree up every year, like the Friday of Thanksgiving. And so this year I had planned to have it up on Wednesday before. And then what I was going to do is not light it up or anything. And then on Friday I would actually light it up. But I just wanted it up because I thought on Friday, I really thought I was going to get up and go shopping. However, after spending all night with my girlfriend sitting there at the table having coffee, of course that didn't happen. But yeah, so that's where we are right now. I'm just very hurt that it got to this. Like, I never would have guessed this from them. Like, they just were not willing to work anything out. And like I said, when I realized that they were thinking that they were on one less room and they were going to lose money, I'm like, no, I don't want you guys to lose money. That's not our intent. Like, you know, if you budgeted thinking this particular amount, we'll just cut our loss. We have someone else that can do it. This way you guys aren't out of any more money. Like, I mean, I don't understand why that was not computing to them. But anyway, it's all said and done now. We did the ACH dispute, and we'll just have to find out between the two banks having a rivalry and us trying to come up with, you know, a resolution. We'll see what happens. But anyway, so that's that order of business. As far as my unemployment, I am still not paid. I am still not able to reach anyone. My life is a living hell right now because it's stressing me out. I'm very, very concerned as to why I can't get a hold to anybody. I can't get a concrete answer on anything. So it's totally stressing me out. I need to see a check. I need to see some money. And I will say this. I mentioned this before in my vlog, but I'm going to mention it again. Because I want to warn other people, let them know, when you're dealing with the TWC, which is Texas Workforce, they make it almost impossible for point of contacts. And I don't understand why. Because the way I see it is, when it comes to this money, you've worked, you've earned it. You're not asking for anything that's not rightfully yours. It's kind of like Social Security. You worked, you earned it. It should be there for you. And why would they want to make it so difficult for you to legitimately get money that is owed to you? Behooves me. I don't get it at all. I'm just like, you know, the people at the customer service line are awesome. They're very friendly. They're very professional. They're very understanding. But the people that actually make the decisions, they don't return your calls. They really could care less. I mean, you know, and it's really kind of sad. It really is kind of sad. But yeah, so anyway, I'm kind of like at a dilemma here. My car payment is going to come up due here on the 19th. The 19th. I want to have my money before my car payment is due. I'm hoping that I'm going to have my money before my car payment is due. I don't know at this point. I feel very, very, very up in the air. Like I feel like nothing's concrete. I feel like I don't have anything that I can call mine at this point. And it really, really bothers me. So anyway, I'm trying so hard to deal with that. My emotions are all over the place. And yeah, so that is the next order of business. Now, I will tell y'all a little thing that I got from my brother is, okay, my mail. I don't know what this is. What is this? Look at this, y'all. This box is so heavy. And I think my brother gave me some Brazilian nuts. I'm thinking that that's what's in this box. It came from my brother. He texted me 2 days ago and said he sent me a package. And I love Brazilian nuts. A fun fact about me. So I think my brother sent me Brazilian nuts because this box is super heavy. So I need to open it up as soon as I get in the house, and I will share with y'all. We'll open it up when we get in the house together, because I definitely can't open up in this car. It's super heavy, and so I'm pretty sure that that's what it is. So I'm excited. I can't wait to see what's in it, but I have such a sweet brother. He is so kind, so loving, and I cannot wait to see. So anyway, I'm going to head my bum bum in the house right now, and then we'll open up this package together. Okay, so I am trying to open up this box because I don't have the phone on the... tripod. So I'm trying to do this with one hand. Oh my gracious, I have the best brother in the world, y'all. He sent me all my favorite things from home. This is a bag full of Brazilian nuts. I could eat nuts for days now. This man is the best ever. You guys, I love my brother so much. Like, you have no idea. I could tell you guys 1,000 times and you just won't even get it. Like, oh my God. And he sent me the chocolate cream drop. Let's see how many did he send. One, two. He sent me 3 cream drops, and then this bag is completely full of Brazilian nuts. I cannot believe it. Oh my gracious. comment below if you've ever had the old-fashioned cream drops. These are the real ones, not the ones that you can get in the stores, like, you know, any little random Walmart or whatever. These are, you buy by the pound, and they are, like, they're the real deal. Like, these are the bomb.com, y'all. Oh, one of them got, oh, like, this bag got squished a little bit, but that's okay. Like, I am not even going to complain because I got the best brother in the world. But comment below, and I'll send you a bag. How's that? I will be super nice. If you have not ever tried these and you want to try them, comment below. Or if you tried them and you like them and you would like a bag of them, comment below. And if several of you comment, then I'll pick a name. Like, I'll draw a name out of all the ones that comment that they will. I have one more inside of here, so I have three. And of course, I would not send you the one that's all mashed up. I'll send you another one because I can eat those myself. But like, this one looks really good. It's not squished. And I will send you one because I would want you to have something that is so good. These are like my favorite. I grew up eating these with my mom. This was my mom's favorite candy. And they came from South Boston, Virginia. Supply line, South Boston, Virginia, 1 pound. Oh my gracious, y'all. I definitely will share them with you. So comment below. Like I said, if several of you comment, then I'll have to draw names. But if only one of you comment, then only that one will get them. But I will gladly, gladly share a bag of these because you all mean just that much to me. And I don't share this with anybody. So y'all, I must love y'all. So anyway, I am going to close out this vlog at this point. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. It's been a fantastic time chatting with y'all, but it's been a not so fantastic day for me. So comment, rate, and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that notification bell. And really comment below so we can get this thing rolling as far as which one of you is going to get a bag of candy. And I will see you guys in tomorrow's vlog. Bye.